Good evening and welcome to Arizona Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. General Motors announced yesterday that it plans to open an IT innovation center in Chandler. It's a move that could mean 1,000 new jobs in the Southeast Valley. Here to tell us more is Chandler Mayor Jay Tibshraeny. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
What is an IT innovation center?
An IT innovation center, at least in this instance, is a center where GM will do research and development for software products to put in their cars and their automobiles and what have you. So it's going to be for information technology services, software development.
So basically, a GM car in the near future, you leave the door open and a voice says, you left the door open. That voice was probably developed or programmed here in Arizona.
We're one of four.
One of four. Where are the other four?
This is a new concept because they're taking their information technology software development, and it used to be outsourced. And they're taking it and doing it internally now. So they've located four of these to help them develop the software. One of them, obviously, Chandler, Arizona, in Michigan, a suburb of Atlanta, Georgia, and Austin, Texas are the other ones.
Why Chandler? Why did you guys get this?
Well, besides being known as a Southwestern innovation and technology hub, that's one reason. But that corridor is very, very strong. But this was a team effort. I think they looked at Arizona, and with Arizona Commerce Authority and GPEC and Chandler partnering and working on this together, I think they kind of, because of maybe Intel and some of the other high-profile companies that located in that corridor, they said Chandler. And plus, they're going to lease, so they have a developer that can build them a building fairly quickly. That building has not started construction yet, and it's a 200,000-square-foot building. They want it to be up and running a year from now. So they'll work close with the city. We have good expertise in turning around projects and getting them up and running. So I think there was a lot of factors in locating in Chandler.
Where will the building be located?
It'll be at the 101 and the 202 in Chandler. People that are familiar with Chandler Fashion Mall in Chandler, this is just south of there.
Okay, so it's going to be near that hub, that hollowed out building? I mean, we got to do something with that building.
Well, maybe we'll get another high-tech company to locate in there eventually. That's the game plan.
What about incentives? A lot of folks, they're not excited about the idea of the city, of the state, offering incentives to folks like GM. How important were incentives in this deal?
Well, we're dealing with a national competition for these, and incentives were important. We're very prudent in Chandler, and I know the state is also, about when and how you offer them, and you look at all of the factors involved with that. But there was incentives on both of our ends to get this. I doubt that we offered more incentives than whoever we were competing against, but I think those do help to secure these kind of projects.
As far as the city is concerned, it was reported Arizona Republic had $1,200 for the first 750 jobs and then $900 for the next 250 with a cap at, I believe, 1,000 jobs and or 1.13 million, something along
those lines. We're about 1.1 million. I think the state has some money into based on some other things. But it is job-based performance, and there is a cap on it. And we looked at the numbers, and it made sense.
It made sense for them, obviously, as well. What about having ASU nearby, and even U of A down the road and nearby in a sense as well? How much of a factor?
They're going to be hiring, 1,000 people. A lot of them are going to be information technology graduates. They say 30 to 35% of the people they hire will be new graduates. That means they're looking at your university system. Can you support that structure? So not only were they favorably impressed with Arizona State University and University of Arizona, but they're looking at educational opportunities within 500 or 600 miles of that location. So that takes them into California and Colorado and Nevada, New Mexico, and so on and so forth. So they're looking at that, and they were fairly impressed with what they would have to draw on to locate folks at that facility.
Airport nearby a factor as well?
They didn't mention it, but I'm sure it is. We have a great airport in Phoenix Sky Harbor, so that was good. And transportation, obviously, very important, and that was good too.
So we're talking about 1,000 jobs, correct?
Correct.
What kind of skill level? You referred to that earlier as far as what they kind of were looking at, but give us a better indication of skill level and corresponding salary ranges.
He didn't give me the salaries. They call them high-wage jobs, but information technology degrees from universities would be your skill level, so which is good news for people even starting school now. Everybody's always wondering, what should I get my degree in? Well, this is another area. We have engineers at Intel and information technology at General Motors. So that there'll be a lot of college graduates, obviously.
Now, and are these new jobs or are these transfer jobs?
These are new jobs.
So these are people that basically will be hired out here as opposed to coming from other areas.
True. And what we're looking at it from Chandler's perspective, it'll be new people coming in. And even if they're not hired from within the state, they'll be moving into Chandler, hopefully, or the East Valley and buying homes and adding to our economic base.
Last question. We talk a lot when you're on the show about the Price Road Corridor,
right,
and trying to make that and turning it into a technology hub. Is this in the Price Road Corridor?
This is right smack dab in the middle of the Price Road Corridor. It's helping cement our reputation as a regional hub for technology and innovation. So it was a good addition to our community, a Fortune 500 company, adding to some of the great companies we already have in that corridor.
And how long did it take for this deal to happen? Was this something that happened kind of quickly,
no,
or they've been looking at this site for quite a while?
We've been working on this since last summer.
Wow.
Yeah, early last summer. So these things take a lot of time, and there's a lot of competition.
And we're going to see the people up and running. You said about a year they're going to get that thing built?
They want to be up and running a year from now.
Wow.
Occupying that building.
Well, congratulations. Sounds like things are happening out there.
A lot more to come, too.
All right. Sounds good. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks.